outside when you're ready. First things first. There you are. Just because you didn't agree to meet doesn't mean you can keep me waiting. See, I wanted to talk to you for a bit. I haven't told you right about the deal. Did you get happy yesterday? No, I haven't. You better not be lying. If you blab, I'm going to make you swallow a coughing hole. Or coughing. You still have that thing we picked up at the stairs? Why she including herself in a lie? My grandpa knows a lot about the village history. We should talk to him about that, what happened yesterday. After she just said she didn't want to talk to nobody. You know where my house is, right? See you there. Don't keep me waiting. Still wondering why she keeps saying we. See the last signboard? Hey, go find somewhere else to be. No one's got business with me. Seriously, he's spending all this time with you. That's so unfair. You can be such a jerk. What did you call me? What's his deal? Kiki should know better than to talk back to me like that. That's enough, comrade. Be kind to your younger brother. I was being kind. It's not like I hit him or anything. Anyway, we've got more important things to discuss, right? The mask belonged to that poor ogre. Where did you find this? He bumped into it, the ogre. Yesterday at the Festival of Masks. I tried talking nice to it and everything, but it dropped the mask, and yeah. I would never have thought that the ogre would still be gracing our festival with its presence. What do you mean, still? I thought the ogre was a scoundrel that attacked the village. I suppose it's time I told you. See, the truth of what happened to the ogre is the other way around. What do you mean? You should hear this, too. You also met the poor ogre, or the ogre pond, as it's rightly named. Let me tell you the story passed down through our family generations. A bit of a long story to tell, is that alright? So what, he stopped the other three from mischief? The story has been passed down in our family by word of mouth. I learned it from my father. The story of truths, a story that must never be told to the rest of the village. Must never speak of it to others. A long time ago, a man came to Kitakami for a foreign land. The people of the village feared the man and the ogre who looked so different from them. And so they refused to let the travelers come anywhere near the village. The man and the ogre were saddened that the villagers did not welcome them. But they were happy just to have each other, so they settled quietly in a cave on a mountain. There was only one villager who pitied the two travelers, the village mask maker. He made several masks for the man and the ogre. The masks were brilliant works adorned with gems that the man bought from somewhere far away. By wearing the mask, the travelers could hide their true faces and mingle with the villagers. The man and the ogre were overjoyed. They thanked the mask maker for his kindness. Wearing the mask, the man and the ogre started secretly joining the village festival. The mysterious pair soon became able to talk to the village because of their brilliant mask. In fact, rumors about them quickly spread far and wide, even to distant lands. But rumors of exquisite shining masks attract more than just innocent curiosity. A group of greedy Pokemon soon made their way to the land of Kitakami. These Pokemon sneaked into the cave which that man and ogre lived, and tried to make off with the masks, which were carefully stored away. The man happened to be there. He managed to hold on to one of the masks, but he was not strong enough to protect them all. The Pokemon stole the other three. Several hours later, when the ogre returned to the cave, it found its beloved home in ruin, and all that was left were signs of a struggle and a teal mask. The ogre donned the mask and went down to the village, perhaps in search for its friend. It found the greedy Pokemon there, gloating over their stolen masks, and defeated them. The villagers, of course, had no idea what was happening, nor why. All they saw was a raging ogre, and they left in great fear. The villagers thought the three Pokemon had fallen prey to the farm trying to protect the village from an ogre. To honor their sacrifice, the village named them the Loyal Three and inherited whatever the hell that word was. Wounded and weak, the ogre returned to his cave along with great sadness. It's terrible. Ogrepon didn't deserve that, and the Loyal Three, they're the worst. The story everyone's been told in the complete opposite truth. They gotta hear this. Calm yourself, Carmine. I told you to keep it to yourself. Well, the villagers believed their own version of history. They revere the Loyal Three, so how could they react to being told that they've got it all wrong? They'd probably get angry. Exactly. Back when this all first occurred, the mask maker, that is to say, our ancestor, tried desperately to tell the truth of the matter. Nobody would take him seriously. In fact, it said that he was persecuted as a heretic. Oh, that really gets my blood boiling. In the end, the mask maker chose to protect his descendants by keeping his mouth shut. However, he kept the truth alive, passed down from generation to generation as a family secret. See, Kiki doesn't know the whole story yet, does he? He shouldn't. No, I've never spoken to him about it. Why do you ask? Oh, he's really like the ogre. He's practically obsessed. And he's been trying to one-up me as if he knows more about Ogrepon than I do. Well, I can't say what's going on with that boy, but he always was a sensitive child. It wouldn't surprise me if he somehow intuited the truth. I promise to tell Kirin the whole truth when the time is right. Until then, take care not to breathe the word of truth to anybody. I can't tell. I noticed the jewel in his forehead was chipped. I might be able to fix it. Would you mind leaving a mess with me for a while? Maybe you got chipped when it fell down the stairs. Since Grandpa's offering, let's get it all nice and fixed up before we give it back to Overpond. Don't you worry, I'll be sure to take good care of this. To see Ogrepon again, but its mass is getting fixed. We'll have to come first. For now, we should carry on orienteering before Kiki gets suspicious. I bet we'll find Kiki just killing time somewhere in town. What are you and my sister talking about? Oh, I see. So, about those signs, the last one is a bit of a hike away. It's in the Paradise Barrens on the other side of Oni Mountain. We'll need to head over the mountain and down towards the northwest. You go ahead, I'll catch up. Why'd you lie to me? This dude really over here acting like he getting his heart broken. Damn. Try to get that thing. I already caught it, so. Honestly? Oh, I got it already. Looking for a Fable? I don't think I have a Clefable. Well, we're gonna change that real quick. Yeah, I'll just do it alone. Oh, we got a Clefable. We're both of these going to be able to master ball. and go. That's a sliver. Is it apparent this barren is probably a lonely place, huh? According to the legends, the ogre used to be seen around here lots. Before we check out the sign, could you battle me? Alright, let's heal up our Pokemon. I think he knows. I think he knows. Can't keep up. That's a candy apple. Ooh, man, I'm getting sleepy. That's the candy apple Pokemon. After they take this picture, I'm about to end the stream. That's why. We should go check on the sign. Come on, let's get this over with. If you see a shadowy figure approaching you outside the village at twilight, be wary. Don a mask once and hide your face. Do so, and whether the shadow is a man or a monster, you will pass each by as fellow mask wearers. If you should meet the shadow, then you have no mask in hand, and pray that it is only a man. If it is, you will live to see another day, and you will remember to never forget your mask again. But if it's the ogre to meet, once it sees your face, your soul will be forfeit, and you shall never return to the village. In the old days, everyone carried masks wherever they went. Ayla heard that he's the reason for the Festival of Math because our ancestors came up with the idea. But I don't really like that they didn't sign here. It's because the ogre seems sort of scary and everyone's afraid and drew it away. But I'm pretty sure the ogre must have been lonely on his own. Left behind, treated like some kind of outcast. Think so too, huh? Wanna take that last photo? What am I doing without a sound now? But I've got a struggle with my Pokemon. I'm heading home. I do not think I have a Sandshrew. So we're gonna do here. We'll save this here. And we will get back to this tomorrow.